pledging the job puts protection in the world, and that I think, and we think, that it goes with us.
Definitely. You know, if you don't enjoy your job, you can never perform. Yes. So it should come from within, and I think everybody should follow this.
Good afternoon, sir. So we feel highly honored, like we are sitting in front of you, such a great personality of our university. And we think that we are lucky to have a conversation with you. So I demand you and my colleague Sakshi are here to have a conversation with you and to inspire our society to have the knowledge in vibrantly. So
my pleasure,
Thank you, sir. So may we start?
Yeah, please.
So my first question is like, what is your success mantra? Which is what inspired you to be on such a high position?
Everybody strives for success, beta, and I feel there is no substitute for hard work. There are three ingredients of success. One is hard work, second is concentration, third is perseverance. So if you have all three, success is bound to come.
So what would you do in your life?
See, first you have to you have to study for job. Then once you do hard work, that is also
you have to
make your mark in your job. That is also as bigger challenge as coming into the job is.
Yes.
So rather more. So then you have to, you know, keep doing that, keep that momentum on to whatever you have achieved, to preserve that. When there is no end to, you know, competition, and there is no substitute for hard work. You have to keep working hard every day, I think.
Yes, sir, as you asked for competition, we know that to achieve something, we have to pass through obstacles. Many obstacles are there. I want to know that what obstacles or difficulties you face in your life to reach such a high position.
See, difficulty, main thing is to, you know, convince yourself to work that hard. And then you, to maintain that momentum also, you have to train your mind, you have to curb many other activities. So it happens with us also now, like sometimes you want to go for a function or a wedding or a close friend's function, but the job priorities tells you not to go. So you have to take a call, and I think I have been taking a call in favor of my job only.
That's really appreciable. So, sir, I think police are, like, it's my own experience that police is for our protection, but still we are afraid of police. Like, we take a U-turn if we see some traffic police in front of us.
See, I'll tell you, this society gets the police which it deserves. This is a very pertinent saying. If you are taking a U-turn, then that means you also know that some illegality is being committed.
Yes.
If you are on the right side of law, nobody is going to trouble you. But still, you know, as the Britishers were here and it was a colonial rule, so a lot of fear of law was instilled in the minds of people. Now, with the passage of time and our democracy progressing, so we are replacing that. The fear of law is diluted. But at the same time, society, you need to generate respect for law.
Yes.
That respect is not coming. So that part we have to, that gap is there. We also keep training our officers to make sure that a common man feels that police is your friend, where the criminal, they should be scared of you.
Yes.
That is the perfect system.
Swachh Bharat Abhiyan is such a big campaign, and our school is also following that. But I think, like, we also see many people throwing garbage on the roads. Do you think some steps should be taken against them?
See, I told you, we need to, you know, uplift ourselves as a society.
Yes, sir.
The very important thing is that a lot of people are conscious about their rights, but nobody talks about their duties. That is the catch. So if we are all conscious and we do our duty and we think it is a religious duty to make us keep our area clean, our city clean, I don't think we'll have a problem. So we need to educate our people, and this habit has to be inculcated.
Yes.
It might take some time, but we should keep our efforts on.
Yes, sir. Sir, we know that your father and your grandfather were also in the same field. That chickens only inspired you, or something else inspired you?
I think that also to some extent, and probably destiny.
Yes, sir.
I think destiny plays also a very important role where one lands up in life. So that it, I take it that way.
Yes, sir. So what is the importance of discipline in your life? What do you mean by discipline in your life?
See, discipline means, as I shared with you, wherever your heart says and jumps, hey, we can do this, so sacrificing our professional life, there you have to train your mind and keep it under check. Give preference to the professional matters more than the personal matters. That is basic discipline.
Sir, could you please tell us about the zeal and enthusiasm for the young generation to join Indian Army or such?
So, armed forces, you know, have been a very sought after career, and I would definitely want, because you know, wearing a uniform is a lot of pride.
Yes, sir.
So I would definitely want, and I would encourage the youngsters to join the armed forces, and so that you can represent your country in some way.
Yes,
and especially on the international borders and all, where there is a lot of challenge.
Yes, sir.
So, sir, what is the outlook of your commanding soldiers over here? How they are looking towards this?
See, we keep encouraging and motivating our officers, but police has one big problem. That is a lot of working hours for us. That is the main issue.
Yes. Sir, like, I want to know about your personal life. Like, are your kids also following the same path, or they want to become something else?
We all want our children to do well. So I have got one son, and I keep guiding him. So I hope he is able to achieve something in life. We can only hope and pray.
Is he also wanting to become like you as a commissioner or something else?
We haven't talked on that level because he just joined engineering.
Okay.
So that is his first year. But issue is that, you know, dreaming something and striving for it and putting in that effort is also very important.
Yes.
One can dream of anything, but you need to put in that extra effort to reach there.
Nowadays drug peddling, it's very much common nowadays. So how is your team working for this cause?
See, basically, as a police, we have to work against breaking the nexus between the smugglers and the middlemen and the consumers. And moreover, with the Punjab government initiative, nowadays we are counseling people to join the addiction centers, so that if people stop having drugs, when there is no demand, there will be no supply. So that part we are looking at it very, very seriously.
Sir, what message would you like to convey to the students of our school and the society?
I would like to say there is no substitute of hard work.
Yes.
And one should always maintain maximum possible discipline.
Yes, sir.
And one should always remember one's duties.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Thank
it's
you.
A pleasure. Pleasure. We are highly delighted that you took us the time.
Thank you, sir. I am so happy, and indeed it's a pleasure to have you over.
So
first we were scared, but now you made us so comfortable. Thank you so much.